Welcome everyone. In this presentation, we will be reviewing yet another physical property of minerals, hardness. Of course, the most famous example for demonstrating the variability of hardness in an element is carbon. Same thing that you are also built of. It can be in the form of diamond, the hardest mineral, and the same element can also be graphite, so soft that we can crush it, as seen here by the mixture of graphite and clay we call pencil lead. So, from where this crystal of diamond gains its hardness? Is it the chemical composition? Is it the binding force? But wait, what is hardness? Hardness is formally defined as the resistance of a mineral surface to scratching, and is determined by observing if a mineral is scratched by another material of known hardness or not. Remember, hardness is not tenacity. Hardness is not the resistance of a mineral to breaking or deforming. That is tenacity. Hardness is only related to a scratch, like the scratch shown here which we got on gypsum, since it is softer than the fingernail. And hardness is a fairly useful diagnostic property for used in field identification of minerals. Like sometimes, it may be difficult to differentiate between limestone and sandstone just by looking. But you can tell them apart in the field, since limestone is much harder than sandstone and the limestone should not crumble under a hammer. Hardness is mainly controlled by the strength of the bonding between atoms and partly by the composition and size of the atoms. So, these were the qualitative aspects of hardness. Now let's quantify it. German mineralogist F. Mohs in 1812 selected 10 common minerals, compared their relative hardness and arranged them in order of increasing hardness from soft to hard, and this arrangement is known as Mohs scale of hardness from 1 to 10. This scale placed talc at 1, gypsum, calcite, fluorite, apatite, feldspar, quartz, topaz, corundum in between, and finished with diamond at 10. This Mohs scale of hardness is a scale of relative hardness based on fairly common minerals. But there is a slight subtlety here. Notice the word relative in the definition. This means that the scale is not absolute, and so it is not a linear scale. I repeat, it is not a linear scale. Gypsum is not necessarily twice as hard as talc, and neither diamond is twice as hard as apatite. Remember, Mohs just took some common minerals and arranged them. And so we can also have absolute hardness that we can measure using a scalarometer, which is an instrument that uses a diamond pyramid to measure the absolute hardness. The non-linearity of Mohs hardness is very clear in this graph, as diamond is not just 10 times as hard as talc, but is a mighty 1600 times harder. Now let us see hardness of some minerals which you ought to know. Graphite has hardness of 1.5, and it demonstrates an interesting concept that hardness of a mineral relates to its weakest bond. The covalent bonds of graphite are as strong as that of diamond, only these weak van der Waal bonds make graphite so soft. Diamond has hardness of 10 as its covalent bonds are extremely strong. Before going to calcite, remember hardness is a vector property. Some minerals like calcite and kyanite show varying degree of hardness depending on the direction in which they are scratched. Calcite shows hardness of 2 on its planar faces, here marked by E, but on all the other surfaces, its hardness is 3. Hardness of kyanite varies from 4.5 to 7 depending on the direction from which it is tested. As for some generalizations, most hydrous minerals, halites, carbonates, sulfates, and phosphates are relatively soft. Most sulfides are also soft, but pyrite is an exception with Mohs hardness of 6. Anhydrous oxide and silicates are mostly hard. Some of the materials which will come handy during practical mineralogy are steel plate, steel file, glass, copper coin, and fingernails, all of whose Mohs hardness is given here. Speaking of practical mineralogy, there are a few good practices that must be followed when determining the hardness of a mineral. Sometimes, when one mineral is softer than another, portions of the first will leave a mark which may be mistaken for a scratch. Such a mark can be rubbed off, whereas a true scratch will be permanent. Also, the surfaces of some minerals are frequently altered to another material that is much softer than the original material. Always a fresh surface of the specimen to be tested must be used. Finally, if a mineral is granular or splintery, then it may appear to be scratched by a mineral much softer than itself. It is always advisable when making the hardness test to confirm it by reversing the order of procedure. Try to scratch mineral A by B, but also try to scratch mineral B by A. You must also know about the hardness box, which is a practical equipment that contains various minerals of different hardness. You may also receive an extended hardness box which may have iron nail, glass plate and copper coin in it. That's all for hardness. Quizzes are available on this topic on mineralscience.wordpress.com.